South Carolina and the home whites have already knocked off three top 10 opponents on this schedule. Mississippi State forces 22 turnovers a game. Man, do they get after it.
She said bloodbath, and I thought it was about the wine I picked, and you were mad last night.
Yeah, underway here tonight. Good crowd, as is usually the case at South Carolina. Here's Vivian's on the attack right away, but a misfire. Okori will kick it back outside to Richardson, who averages about 8 points a game. Both of them have both talked about wanting to get up and down, to have a game not in the 50s, but somewhere in the 70s.
It's amazing because these are the two best defenses in the SEC, giving in the low 50s up per game on the defensive end. How about this pair? A couple of offensive opportunities for Mississippi State.
Two offensive rebounds, and I think that's an important piece to what Mississippi State is doing, is for them to get extra opportunities, extra cracks at it.
Morgan Williams going to be a lot of fun to watch, wearing number two for the Bulldogs. Here's Vivian's coming in, averaging 17 a game, one of the best scorers in the conference. The shot clock is down to five. Here's William launching. That was partially tipped. Right back up. Up again. Okori able to get that one to go before the shot clock expired.
Four chances at it, right? Four chances on the first possession. I mean, you have to finish your defense with a box out if you're South Carolina.
Just under 15 points per game for Mississippi State comes off of their second chance opportunities.
Going to be a shove there and a foul. 8:39 to go here in the first. That'll be on Richardson.
You can see why they're north of 36 points per game, Mississippi State, in the paint. Almost 46% of their offense comes from inside the paint. That's a good example why.
The officials tonight, veterans all, Dee Cantner, Tynan Napier, and Bryant Esterline. It's going to be really interesting to see how this game is officiated because of all that activity in the paint you've both mentioned. Is Vivian's from three, and she buries it.
So one player you can't lose, right? I mean, it's the one player on the court. If you're South Carolina, you've got to account for it. Just an open shot.
All I know is the gentleman behind me is screaming, "Where is Vivian's?" So even he knows.
They're locked in here at South Carolina. And a 5-0 lead for Mississippi State, trying to answer the question just how good they are. And this is a pretty good venue to do it in. Davis way downtown, but off the back of the iron, and Okori's there for the rebound. She's 6'5", and really crashes the glass. Vivian's again, inside the three, hits another one, a two-pointer.
Well, it happens quickly, and then they can do this. They can get in their pressure, they face guard, they try to make you make mistakes.
She has a history of playing exceptionally well against South Carolina. She averages about 20 points a game in her career against the Gamecocks. Davis with a little spin, got a good look. Can't hit it, right to Wilson, yes. Asia Wilson with the basket, averaging 16 points coming in. She's having an All-America kind of season, certainly, for the Gamecocks. Also coming back from a tender ankle, she missed a couple of games. Played about 15 minutes in their last win against Alabama. Vivian's again, trying to keep that hot hand, but picked off by Dillingham.
The lack of discipline right now on the defensive glass. South Carolina's got to finish these possessions by putting a body on somebody.
Already five offensive rebounds from Mississippi State. That an airmail, and yet another one in the corner. The shot by William won't fall, and tipped up in control this time, but again, Cox. And they want to run a little bit. Wilson in close, can't bank it in.
They can see what Mississippi State's going to do. Ball entered the post, Kara, a couple bodies come right over. Well, this is a South Carolina team whose bread and butter is the high-low. They score a ton of points in the paint.
William, the point guard, off to Richardson. Vivian's again. And a bounce for Dillingham. Good look, in and out. Another offensive board. William inside, and they move the ball beautifully.
I mean, I'm shocked at how South Carolina is continuing to be outworked. I mean, outworked. If you take away the second chance opportunities, Mississippi State has two field goals. I mean, it's shocking.
Davis got it. She can really heat up. An outstanding three-point threat, too.
What a physical specimen. Has all the tools as a basketball player. Just tremendous frame, able to shoot the three. And I'll tell you, she has played very well against their ranked opponents. She sort of relishes these matchups.
Crowd here at South Carolina hollering for defense and hollering for a rebound on this end, too, because the Bulldogs are getting all of them. William on the drive, the quick point guard tied up on the play, no foul, and they're going to win it back on a possession arrow. It's an outstanding defensive stop.
So this is a drag in transition, and Vic Schaefer was calling for it. Why? Because where is Okori's defender? Elena Coates is too far sloughed off. She's into the paint, and that gives her the opportunity. And you see Morgan William with a nice drive there and the dump off to Richardson. Here's what I'm seeing defensively from South Carolina. If you're sloughing off certain players and you say, hey, we're not going to guard them because they can't shoot jumpers, you better get out and check them out when the shot goes up. So if you're far away from them because it's your scheme, you still have box-out responsibilities with your player.
They're plus 10 on the glass on the year, but you're right, it's been a lack of discipline.
Coach did a great job keeping that alive, but Wilson and one, and she'll be going to the line. Asia Wilson. So tough to handle, the 6'5 junior looking for a three-point play.
You talk about her activity. She comes a long way for that rebound. She is a lefty. She gets past the defender, and you compound the mistake by fouling her.
And slapping her hands and saying, let's go, let's go. Trying to rev up her team, 9-6, Mississippi State. Wilson at 16-7. And also a premier shot blocker. She has 5 points. The foul went on Okori. So South Carolina battling their way back after a chilly start. Now within two here in the first quarter. Chapel dishing down to Okori. Nice feed and a basket. Mississippi State trying to snap an 8-game losing streak to South Carolina. And will this be the night they finally do that? Here's Harris trying to take that baseline. Finds an open shooter. Davis too strong. Rebound tip controlled by Johnson. And now William will back it out. Off the fake. Her two-pointer in the air. Wilson with another rebound. Wilson, an All-America candidate, certainly Elena coaches too, a scrap on the floor, and the Bulldogs come away with it.
Well, I love that. Dillingham was the first to the floor. Typically, first to the floor is going to win out in a 50-50 ball. Two bodies from Mississippi State got on the ground. And if you're going to win on the road, you've got to bring more energy than the home team.
Vivian's getting ready to check back in. Dillingham fires. Got it, a three-pointer.
John Staley's incensed. That should have been a 10-second call on Mississippi State. They did not get it over half court before that shot clock hit 20.
First quarter, two teams undefeated inside the SEC. Mississippi State overall undefeated at a perfect 20-0. They played a tough schedule. The entry pass Wilson, and over the back foul. They may get William for that one. And we have a timeout with 3:37 to go in the first.
Champion, it's a whole lot to lose a possession like that.
Both of the threes from Mississippi State have come off what were South Carolina turnovers, but that last one should not have counted.
Coates in the corner, comes in averaging a double-double to toss that one away. Wilson went for the save and was able to deflect it off of Chapel and keep it.
I admire how hard Mississippi State is working on the defensive end of the floor. Both teams are, but one care, they're applying tremendous pressure on the ball. And then anytime the ball tries to be entered, the post players working so hard to prohibit catches or coming with a quick double. And you've got to, because South Carolina will eat you up in the post if you allow Wilson and Coates to get going.
Here's Cuevas Moore, who's now in running the point, the 5'6 junior from the Bronx, who lately has been shooting it really well.
Watch Mississippi State's weak side guards. Those are the players away from the basketball, in the paint, to your point, Doris, right here. Vivian's with the nice early help and creates the travel there. So on the pass, they don't have to go from outside the paint to get to the paint. They're already there disrupting the rhythm. Check out it right here, Vivian's backside again, making it difficult for Wilson to catch.
They do such a good job of getting on the midline, right? Those weak side defenders, everybody's head in the maroon jerseys is on a swivel on the defensive end.
Vivian's back in. She had 5 quick points. Launches again, but can't get that one to go. And on this occasion, no second effort from Mississippi State, although they have had a ton of offensive rebounds early. And another well-run play here on the strike by Asia Wilson. She has 7. Wilson, an All-America candidate, missed 2 games with a sprained ankle. Came back on Thursday, played 15 minutes in a victory against Alabama. They say she is good to go for 40 if needed tonight Willingham with a miss in close. And there's Wilson again. Now she's already ripped down four rebounds. Coates off the fake, draws the foul. Well, she got hit by Okori and will be at the line to shoot two.
This is my one question for Mississippi State. And you have to give a ton of credit to Vic Schaefer because he has methodically built this program. And now what a start for him at 20-0. But he was telling us earlier that he had a conversation with Gino Auriemma about improving his offense. I'm going to let you do the promo, I promise.
Well, thank you. It's all about Super Tuesday in the Big 12 and the SEC. First at 7. Number 2, Kansas, taking on number 18, West Virginia. Then at 9, Kentucky and Tennessee. Super Tuesday, 7 and 9 on ESPN. Please continue.
Yeah, so what I wonder is, and Kerry, you alluded to this earlier, right, when you were talking about the rebounding for South Carolina. For Vic Schaefer, there's a number of kids you can come off, right? Morgan Williams only made 9 threes. She is shooting 50%, but she only takes 6 shots a game. Do you believe, Kara, that this Mississippi State team has enough offense to compete for a Final Four and a national championship?
I believe they have enough offense to compete for a Final Four.
Yeah.
And, you know, a lot of this, as you know, is matchup specific. But they turn you over, they can create extra possessions that way. We've seen their offensive rebound capability. They can create extra possessions that way. And then a final piece to them, I think that's really important, is getting to the free throw line. So there are ways you can mitigate maybe not having true blood shooters and scorers on the court in all 5 positions if you're able to create extra possessions in other areas.
Stopped out of play there by the Bulldogs, and with 19 seconds on the shot clock.
Well, to your point, they are 4th in the country in free throws attempted, 4th in the country in free throws made. Those turnovers, extra possessions. It's a good formula, and I admire what he's achieved at Mississippi State because they did not have this kind of sustained success prior to his arrival.
Took them to the Sweet 16 last year. His eyes on the kind of run that he saw as an assistant at Texas A&M, and they won the whole thing. Coach will get that one to go.
That's it right there, right? Drawing the help, drawing the collapse, and then putting it up for your big players to finish. South Carolina doing a much better job of that here.
And all of their field goals have been in the paint. Chapel, the wide-open shooter, won't take it. Dominic Dillingham shut down as well. Shot clock down to 5. From the corner, Chapel. A lot of iron, but it won't drop in. Right back up McCollum.
See, that's frustrating because you spent that entire defensive possession face-guarding Victoria Vivian, so they basically negated in this basketball game. You've come off the appropriate shooters, but then you give up an offensive rebound again.
Happened time and time again here in the first quarter, which is winding down at South Carolina. McCown, by the way, is 6'7". Could have a real impact tonight, depending on how much he's in. Wilson wanted a pass. Gray will drive and kick. Here's Harris. Right to Coach, and another one for her. So a one-point game in the final seconds of the first quarter.
You can see Gray in that far right corner of your screen face guarding Victoria Vivians. That's her assignment.
William taking her time. 7 to get off a shot. Dillingham with a jumper. That clangs away. Vivians went in for the rebound and out of play off her with 0.3 showing before the end of the first. Mississippi State by 1. This is their highest ranking in program history, and they do have the lead next to us and go where she should be, which is right behind the basket, Karen.
I love it, guys. I'm going to try and give you a different vantage point, particularly for Mississippi State in terms of their interior defense and their weak side defense, how they're trying to take away the South Carolina high-low game.
She abandons us at the table, and apparently because the game is 6 o'clock next Monday, she only works in prime time, so she's not coming with us there either.
Prime time, Kara Lawson-Chapel up top. Dillingham had a tough first quarter, went 1 for 6, and a whistle in the paint. And that foul will go against Coates, her first. Gamecocks, a high-scoring offense. They average 80 points a game. And as we've already detailed, most of those, over half of those, come in the paint.
Well, you look at the combination of Coates and Wilson. 13 points, 8 boards in the quarter. Nice block by Asia Wilson, South Carolina's all-time leader in that respect already.
Harris, the freshman from Indiana, and the number two point guard directing traffic. Just getting started here in the second quarter. Harris with a lot of dribbling. Finally looking for Coates, and she is taken down as that is knocked out of play.
Well, interesting that South Carolina is playing with two-point guards, Harrison, as you see the block by Asia Wilson just so long.
Also with 31 blocks to lead South Carolina. Calling for the ball on the entry, right back up for two.
Well, it's so effective. It's really just a timing play, right? You get the cut by Wilson. The time of the pass has got to be perfect.
Now Wilson leading South Carolina back from an early deficit and to their first lead tonight, 17-16. They've been trailing by as many as seven. William with a 13-footer for two. I know you really like her game.
I really do. The fact that she has improved her shooting in the first 2 years of her career, last year in part because of injury, she was in the mid-30s.
Quick shot and a whistle and a foul as Gray gets hit right around the foul line. Alicia Gray, the junior from Sandersonville, Georgia, hit by McCowan, will pick up her first.
See, we're going to show you a highlight of Kara Lawson against Mississippi State, but right now, you know, you think she would have liked to have had the advantage as a Tennessee player trying to deal with Coates and Wilson of being where she is now. We're going to start you on the end line, Caitlin, let you work.
No, we got to practice today, and there were a couple of people who were reminding Kara about the heartbreak she inflicted on Mississippi State in her playing days at Tennessee.
She said she had three game winners in her career, all three against Mississippi State. A bus driver comes over to the sideline. He goes, I don't really want to see you again.
Tied at 18. And we expect this game to go right down to the wire tonight. William back up top for Richardson. Here's Vivian's trying to heat up again. And the point guard of the lane, back for Richardson. Dribble it off her leg and out of play. Brianna Richardson with the turnover, the senior. She graduated in just 3.5 years, getting her degree in December.
How about that?
They turn it over.
Little miscue, and again, you wonder about the cumulative toll of this pressure from Mississippi State. They concede so little to you. What you think is going to be a simple inbounds pass becomes something else.
Again, they forced 22 turnovers a game. They just turned a good Alabama team over 29 times. And a reach-in foul inside the lane with 8:10 to go in the first half. They'll get Kleine for that one. So Vivian's up and over the top of Richardson, who can be a very effective scorer. Vivian's with a jump shot. Gray to push the tempo. Kicked around and picked off again. They force another turnover. Richardson against Wilson. Went for the block and commits the foul instead. So a chance for a three-point play for the Bulldogs.
Well, again, the activity, the pressure. And off the turnover, another opportunity for an end-one situation.
So Richardson will be at the line where she hits 75%. The Bulldogs get to the line a ton, among the best in the country at getting to the foul line, and they make 71%. You mentioned that Brianna Richardson graduated in 3.5 years, got a degree in December. The next day, she notched her first double-double of the season, 19 points and 10 rebounds. That was a pretty good week.
Well, she was smarter after the BA degree.
Yeah, right. To get that degree. Coates will swing. High pass, nearly picked off. Trying to get it down low for Wilson. Yes. Not to be denied, and she has 11.
Well, how about that, Kara Lawson? Between defenders, the ability to catch it and finish it by Asia Wilson.
It's too much size, and you talked about how their help side is always there. You know where help side can't get when you're a guard? That's up in the air. You throw it up to the bigs, you throw it up to Coates, you throw it up to Wilson. Doesn't matter where weak side is, they're still going to make a play.
Richardson straight on, got a great look and knocked it in. But the combination of Wilson and Coates have 17 of the South Carolina points already. Davis across midcourt. Mississippi State by two. Now Cuevas Moore to call out a play. She can be electrifying. Wilson takes a stumble. Davis can't hit the three. William quickly into the offensive zone. The junior point guard from Birmingham, Alabama. We talked about her shooting improving from 35% a year ago to 51% this year. Dillingham. Bold start for her shooting. Vivian's got off to a nice start. Nice job for 2 points.
Her ability to make contested shots is impressive. This is a player who 5,000 plus points in high school.
5,745 high school points. That was the all-time record when she left high school, not in any one state, in the whole country in girls basketball. Over the top, controlled by Wilson. And if she's going to get that, and she's getting it a lot, it could be a long night for the Bulldogs.
And the only person who can catch it is her. They are dominating with Coates and Wilson, as most teams struggle with that combination.
Dillingham trying to heat up, and yes, that's one way to do it, a three-pointer.
Well, this young woman has worked so hard to become a better offensive player. Missed six games with an injury, had been playing and shooting well prior to that.
Well, she's always been noted as a superb defender. Kleine penetrating there, and she'll draw the foul. Danny Kleine, the sophomore from New Jersey, and she'll be at the line.
So what do you do to take away weak side defense? You get it in the middle of the floor and go high low. We talked about the size of the weak side help, and Dillingham just too small. Just too small in there. Great job by Asia Wilson. What a pass. I mean, what a pass to drop it right in between three defenders. If Mississippi State allows South Carolina to get the ball in the middle of the floor, there's no help for that. They're at a size and athleticism disadvantage with Coates and Wilson.
And that's where I think McCowan has got to be a step closer, because you've got to do something to impede the vision of Elena Coates at that high post. Now, tell you what, Elena Coates, and I said this to her at the SEC Media Day, I know Elena or Asia Wilson is a Player of the Year candidate. Elena Coates is one talented basketball player with the ability to hurt people inside, as you've seen already.
And having a great year.
Yeah, concede nothing. She has been so consistent all season.
Now 15 points, 11 rebounds. That's her average, a double-double coming into this one. Dillingham around the back. Nifty move there. How about the pass? And McCowan with the finish.
So pretty.
That was slick. 29-23. Mississippi State showing a lot more offensive potential this season as opposed to last year. On a high post, Asia Wilson looking for help now. Off Kleine. Tried to cut to the basket and out of play.
Well, Mississippi State on the road.
South Carolina. And right now, Mississippi State with a 6-point lead. They've hit their last five shots. Rashonda Johnson. Here's Richardson to let fly and nails that one. She has 8 points. This is the biggest lead of the night so far for the Bulldogs. And a nice sized crowd here. So far quieted. Coates went for it. And a foul with 3:48 to go here in the second quarter.
Well, there's no question that's a foul, because you have to let the player land. And that's what I like about throwing the ball up to these guys. You get them on the move, you get them on the roll, and Coach just sets a nice little ball screen and then rolls hard to the basket. You throw her up, let her go get it, and you can't position yourself under a player that's already left the floor to go catch the basket.
Dillingham did, and she picks up the foul. How about Dee Kantner? Double duty.
Does a little bit of everything. Extra pay for that?
I think there is an additional stipend. I don't know what it is.
I might have to go out there and start sweeping.
Yeah, we could all use a little help, believe me. Baby needs a new pair of shoes. intended for Wilson, batted away, and the theft. There's 8 turnovers now for South Carolina.
We came on this broadcast talking about who is Mississippi State. The contest of passes is truly a thing of beauty. They try not to let you get comfortable, let you breathe a little bit.
Now Vic Schaefer has always been a coach who hangs his hat on defense. What he's been getting this season is a lot of other great stuff, obviously being 20-0, but a team that can score too.
Yeah, said he sat down with Gino Auriemma over the summer for about 90 minutes trying to pick his brain about how good they are offensively and why.
Richardson with a kick out. Dillingham with a shot clock at 5. Richardson lets fly. In and out. Boy, that was in the cylinder.
Well, much better job by South Carolina on the defensive backboards. I got to believe at the end of that first quarter, that was something Dawn Stanley talked to her crew about.
You think Gino gets a finder's fee for helping Vic Schaefer with his offense?
No, I don't think so. Just the satisfaction that you've helped a colleague.
On the attack, Wilson. Oh, what a tough drive. And count it. And she'll be at the line. There may be no stopping Asia Wilson tonight.
Well, Asia Wilson, one of the things you have to know on the scouting report is she wants to go left. 4-5 ball screen, very difficult to defend, especially when you're talking about McCowan trying to check Wilson in space. That's 9 of South Carolina's 10 field goals now, guys, made by Wilson or Coates.
Foul on McCowan will be her second and a 3-point play. One of the best players in the country, the junior from Hopkins, South Carolina.
And we talk about Mississippi State, points in the paint. As you see, the rebounding is pretty even. 40.7 points in the paint. They're going to get above that if Mississippi State's not careful.
A little shove there with 2:49 left in the quarter on Gray of South Carolina. Dawn Staley now in her 9th year here at South Carolina, but a much longer coaching career than that. You were kind of marveling at how long she's been at it.
We're reading the notes in preparation for this game. It says it's her 17th year. I covered her first season at Temple. I'm like, my God, where is the gear going? The years are falling off the calendar the older I get, Dave O'Brien.
And she's built some program here. McCown in close, and that's a very tough play to stop. She has half a dozen.
You allow that kind of low post position, as you see another pass contested by Morgan Williams. You can't allow that kind of positioning, and she is still hurting from the screen that was set in that 4-5 pick and roll. Wow, she is not that, she keeps grabbing that hip.
...33-26 Mississippi State. Both of these schools undefeated in the Southeastern Conference, the last two remaining unbeaten in the SEC. Wilson, looking for that high-low look, but that's off the backboard. So an errant pass turned over back to the Bulldogs. That was an unforced error. Vivians, she's been quiet since that first quarter and draws the foul on the reach-in. On the guard, Quavos Moore.
Now this is their little bit of a weave, and you could see she steps in Quavos Moore in anticipation. Didn't look like a ton there.
Not much, but it'll be 2 shots. So Vivian's at the line. She makes 76%. She's closing in on 1,500 career points at the college level. You talked about nearly 6,000 points in high school. She's averaged about 20 points a game against South Carolina.
Can you imagine taking that many shots to score almost 6,000 points in high school?
She started playing in the 8th grade. Quavos Moore zipping the pass off Wilson. The save by Coates and tipped right back to South Carolina. Final moments here of the second quarter. Wilson, that same move going in strong, and it drops in, and it's going to be an offensive foul, so wave off the basket.
Yeah, so 3 turnovers in a row by South Carolina, and these are the ones, as you see the rotation by Dillingham, who is one of the best at drawing charges, clearly gets to her spot, clearly an offensive foul. 3 straight turnovers. You talked about it. Quavos Moore had one. Wilson had another one as she goes to the bench with 2. These are the unforced errors that, to me, that you've got to start to minimize if you're South Carolina.
Dominic Dillingham, by the way, with 123 charges taken in her career. And a whistle before the shot, a traveling violation. So turnover again, a minute 20.
It's been effective going inside, but it hasn't been because there isn't competition down there. Trying to force turnovers and make you uncomfortable, Dave.
Coming up on the last minute of the first half. South Carolina with it. Cuevas Moore at the foul line. Can't knock that one down and rebounded away by the Bulldogs. Coming in with their highest ranking in school history at number 4. Vivian's with a jumper, but no. McCowan tangled up with Coates, who commits the foul. And that'll be her second.
Are they giving that 2 shots? Yes.
That'll be McCowan at the line for 2.
Well, again, the offensive rebounds after doing a pretty good job for much of it, and there is a foul. But I thought the foul occurred well before the shot attempt.
Well, the doubleheader on NBA Wednesday kicks off at ESPN beginning at 8 Eastern. The Warriors take Kemba Walker and the Hornets on. And then at 10:30, it's the Lakers and the Blazers. NBA Wednesday at 8 and 10:30 Eastern on ESPN.
Always 2,000 women's basketball, so that's why.
So another one coming for McCowan. Coates also has to go to the bench here for the final less than 1 minute of the half. Wilson and Coates, the 2 big stars for South Carolina, both the 2. 33-26 Mississippi State, but the Gamecocks with the ball. Here's Kleine. He's been really active. Harris looking for an opening. Back out top, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
You can't have ill-advised drives against Mississippi State. When you're driving on a straight line from 15 feet, the rotation is always going to be there for Mississippi State. Look at William beat Harris to the spot and draw that charge.
Don Staley and South Carolina have not trailed at the half for any game so far this season, but they are going to be behind in this one. They only led for 23 seconds. Dish down low and finished off by McCown. Has had a really nice first half. Not noted as a big scorer, but she has helped out on the offensive end. 35-26.
At Mississippi State giving him a cushion right now. Good shape of saying everybody got their hands up.
Cuevas Moore on the drive, got it up in the air to whistle with 1.6 on the clock.
Wow, that's a bad foul by the McCowan.
Yeah, that's gonna be her 3rd.
That's a really bad foul. You're coming over in rotation. You've got to understand you've got to, and you can't put yourself in that position to let the official have that whistle. That changes the next 10 minutes coming out of the next halftime. That is a tough one.
She really has had an impact in this one, too.
No question about it.
Well, you can see Big Schaefer shaking his head, upset with that. She is an outstanding shot blocker, but no sense in going for that shot there. And a time number 5 against number 4. Mississippi State's been an outstanding road team. The heave won't go at the buzzer, but they're trying to go to.
Hey, listen, do a little dance over there, Vic Schaefer. It was a good first 20 minutes for you.
He had a huge smile on his face, and he wasn't backing down. He's really delighted. A lot of coaches, even if they have a 7-point lead at halftime, go, oh, we got to work on this, got to work on this. He's really happy where he is right now.
He was happy.
So just getting started here in the 3rd. And from a big crowd at South Carolina, the Gamecocks open up with a basketball. And Wilson with the first touch. And she had 2 fouls in the first half as Gray lets fly and buries a 3.
So what's your first play? The first look is a Kayla Davis post up. The second one is a pin down screen for Alicia Gray. Get somebody else on the board if you're South Carolina offensively.
That was Alicia Gray's first shot attempt.
And was also the first 3-point make for the Gamecocks tonight. And the fans here have placards they can hold up whenever they make a 3. It's the first time they've been able to do that tonight. They've been holding those as Davis picks up the foul. It's also the first bucket outside the paint this evening for the Gamecocks. So they cut the lead to 4. Morgan Williams, the little point guard at 5'5". She goes around the back, just opening up here in the second half. for Dillingham. Around the back as well. Nifty pass underneath, but Corey could not finish it. Coates with a nice save.
Boy, what a waste. Twice behind the back. Once to her left hand, that time to her right by Dillingham.
It's Wilson. Got a great look. Coates got all tangled up. No foul on the play, and they're howling here at South Carolina. A lot of contact, but no whistle. So the Bulldogs trying to add to their lead. Richardson fires. Corey with a rebound, had it stripped right back out for Dillingham. William off the back of the iron, and Wilson rips it down.
Two 50-50 balls, two maroon jerseys come up with them.
Nine rebounds for Asia Wilson, who has really shown up tonight. She's on the verge of another double-double. Already with 16 points. Coach also has two fouls. Poked away from her, but it'll be kept here on this end by South Carolina with nine on the shot clock.
Who on the perimeter settles you if you're South Carolina, right? I think Asia Wilson is the player that settles them, but one of their guards has to be able to do it. You cannot have your post player be that settling presence all the time. Someone on the perimeter needs to be that.
Coates out of traffic and a foul. That'll be on her, an offensive foul. Number three on Coates.
Come on now. That is a big woman coming right at you. But Dillingham, does she care? No, because this is the second time she's taken a charge on Elena Coates. And again, against Mississippi State, if you are coming on a straight line drive from 15 feet, the rotation will be there every time.
This is a tough kid. She missed a half a dozen games to injury, but gets right in there and takes another charge. She's done that now 124 times. Vivian's lets fly. That clangs away. Coates in foul trouble. Underneath Wilson. They move it quickly for an easy two. 35-33. Wilson has 18. She's made 8 out of 10. Vivian's off balance. That's a wild shot. Richardson tears it away and right back up for two.
I love Richardson and Dillingham. I mean, they just get after it. And they understand that those are the types of play. Those are winning plays right there. Those are winning plays, the one that Richardson makes right there.
And they needed that to grab some momentum back. 37-33. Cuevas Moore, the point guard, getting ready to check back in for the Gamecocks. Davis really dangerous outside the three and the foul. And that's going to be number three on Chinwe Okorie. And tonight after Big Monday, don't miss SportsCenter at night with John Anderson and Steve Levy. Highlights from college and NBA hardwoods, the NHL, Australian Open, and more. SportsCenter at night right after Oklahoma, Texas.
Your two centers for Mississippi State both have three fouls. That's why the McCowan one at the end of the half was important. And this better be on Vivian's. Yeah, it is.
So she'll pick up the personal. 6:52 to go in the third. That's her second.
And what do? You need to attack pressure with aggressiveness, and that's what Gray does right there. You know, Gray is so talented. We saw her at North Carolina, her ability to score the basketball, and I know she's got kind of a quiet personality off of the court, but South Carolina needs her to be more aggressive, more impactful, a little more, I don't want to say selfish on the offensive end of the floor, but look to attack. You can fall into a point when you have great players, when you play with great players, and Coach is a great player, Wilson's a great player, where you stand and watch.
Yeah.
And you say, you know what? I'm going to let them do their thing. I don't want to mess that up. No, you've got to continue to attack.
It's interesting to me that Kayla Davis, whose effort on the defensive end can wax and wane, has drawn the Vivian's assignment.
Okorie trying to get inside in lane, lost it. Gray scooped it up. They forced the turnover. Only four of them in the game. Cuevas Moore won't shoot it. Wilson with a kick. Harris open. Got it, a three. South Carolina surging into the lead. Up by one on a 10-2 run. Richardson went for the pass. Picked off by Wilson. Wilson. Now Davis will wait. And South Carolina certainly grabbing Big Mo here at home. Harris keeps the dribble. Shot clock down to five. Wade out. Count it goes. Count it. How about the shot by Gray? While tumbling on a play and takes the five.
Going to be afflicted with disease. And definitely a tinge of sadness as well that she is not here to be able to see her dream come to fruition. But 3,000 patients that that clinic is going to see and up to 6,000 in the next couple years.
Yeah. Well, listen, the population is aging. And so that becomes more and more of an issue. So it's going to meet a need. There's no question.
Gray had to settle for three on the three-pointer. Did not make the four-point play, but a spectacular shot.
Mississippi State needs to get a quality shot. So as Kara said, who's going to settle? And Morgan Williams has been so outstanding at the point. Can they get a good shot here?
Dillingham with a kick. Williams finds the baseline. Got it up there, but it won't roll in. A second effort, though, and they had a ton of those early in the game to take the lead. Now they're trailing by four. Richardson penetrates, swooping in. Okori back up. No! One chance after another. Richardson had it knocked out of her hands, but a foul with 4:54 to go in the third. That'll go against Alicia Gray, just nailed that sensation.
Interesting how well this team has played since Coates has gone to the bench with third foul. 8-0 run. They've gone small, and going small pushes Wilson to the five. But I think what going small for this team does also is open up the floor on the offensive end of the floor. There's a little more gaps, and if they have some players willing to knock down three-point shots, they can be a better offensive team with Coates off the floor at times.
Asia Wilson with 18 points to lead all scorers. No surprise that she has had a big game at a big stage. In for Vivian's. Now, can she start to heat up?
I love the assignment of Kayla Davis, who I had said again, that can wax and wane. So you put her on the best player and you say, go to work.
Vivian's banks it in, and the look on her face was priceless. Like, I never thought that was going in.
I didn't call that.
But she nails it, and Mississippi State is down one. A 31% three-point shooter. Here's Davis. Trying to take her own three and can't hit that. Rebounded away by the Bulldogs and now the chance to get the lead back. William, the point guard, to set it up. Here's Dillingham. William on the baseline. Quavos Moore all over her. She spins around and airmails her. Up top for Harris. Wilson wants it. Turns in the lane. What a terrific move. And draws the foul.
You know it's coming. You know she wants to go left. And she's still able to get there. I mean, what great patience. And this is a real deal shot fake. I mean, I thought she was shooting it. That's the fourth foul on Okori. That's a brilliant one-on-one move. I think you got to bring help. What did we say in the first half of Mississippi State? How brilliant they were at bringing help against those post players. I think you got to dig down deeper.
So Wilson with 18 points. And a nice touch at the foul line. She makes 69%.
Let's watch the screen that says to Vivian up. I was going to say little screen, but I would not say Chinwe Okori sets a little screen. And we'll give her the bank shot, even though she didn't call it.
42-40 South Carolina. Another one coming for Asia Wilson. Makes one of two. Gray keeps it alive, and she'll draw the foul. Now, I'll tell you what. Her fingerprints are all over this comeback by South Carolina. That'll be number three on Vivian's.
Different player. I mean, a different player these first 6 minutes of this second half. She doesn't show a lot of emotion. She is talented. And
I got to be honest with you. I mean, to me, South Carolina has every aspect needed for a national championship team. You've got the most formidable front line in the country. You know, outside of Baylor, I'm not sure who can match up with them one-on-one in the post with both kids. you've got Kayla Davis, who to me should be an elite scorer. I'd like to see more from her on the defensive end. You've got 2 point guards. You've got Gray, who we can call her the silent assassin. There's enough here for a national championship gap.
Dillingham, long range, and knocks in the three.
And I'm waiting for my amen. I didn't get one last week in Notre Dame, and I'm not getting one now.
Here's the thing, and I agree with you on paper. What we need to see is execution and discipline, possession to possession. Those are the things that I need to see. I agree with you in terms of on the roster, on paper. But what we need to see is that paper manifesting itself in the game at a championship level, and that's what we don't see consistently from South Carolina.
Shot clock is down. I'm going to give you an amen on the discipline.
Knocked out of play. 2:48 to go here in the third. I think you both agree with me that the tournament has a chance to be an absolute blast. You talk about Baylor. That Baylor team is a legitimate national champion possibility, and I don't think they're alone. We've talked a lot about Kelsey Plum, the spectacular year that she's had. That Washington team, they could find their way into the Final Four very easily. Another whistle and a foul here with 2:48 left in the third.
The officials are cooperating with our discussion right now, slowing the game down.
Well, the number one seeds just came off the reveal, potential number ones. UConn, Baylor, South Carolina, Mississippi State. You get no argument from any of us that they belong there right now.
And I know our crew is talking about them, rightly so. Maryland falls to number 9, I believe it was. And when you look at their schedule, you know, the best game on their schedule is UConn, Dave, 87-81. They beat Louisville and they beat Arizona State.
Well, you remember, what your seeding is, what your resume is, can be different than how good you think a team is. Right. Like, I don't think there's 8 better teams in the country than Maryland.
Certainly not.
But from a resume standpoint, maybe that's where they should fall.
Well, brutal schedule, and another foul. A lot of those now. Here at the tail end of the third, they'll get Harris for her second.
I do like that the committee is telling us that the strength of schedule is important. And keep in mind, Brenda, who I adore because she'll play most times anybody anywhere, but this was set up very intentionally. Obviously, she had turnover. She's got a freshman point guard who is absolutely one of the most electric fun players in the country to watch. But you know, scheduling's important philosophically. Where are we age-wise, experience-wise?
William trying to penetrate, flips it up, but won't quite get there. McCowan goes for the save and flips it back to midcourt. So another chance here for the Bulldogs. Grab one of the turnover. Johnson lost it right back to William. Sloppy play here. Johnson picks it off on the weak side and lays it in. Boy, they got very fortunate. And it ties it at 45. Just under 2 minutes to go in the third. Mississippi State undefeated. And a lot of people around the country wondering just how good they are. And taking this show to South Carolina. Up against Asia Wilson, tied up and a foul on the play.
Wow, I don't know about that one.
The reach in by William, and she'll pick up her second foul. Take a look.
We get the benefit of the second look, but I thought on the reach in here, there was a lot of ball. Oh, that's all ball. That's a bad call.
Yep.
It's a bad call, but I like what they're doing with Asia Wilson. Okay, she is playing in a matchup where McCowan has tremendous size, and so don't post her up on the block. Get her to the short corner, let her turn and face, and now let her utilize her strength in the matchup, which is her quickness.
Wilson with another one coming.
I'm just saying, when you reach in and you're Morgan William and you're 5 foot nothing, and you get, I mean, I don't want to call it a block shot. We like to call them block shots to the guards. Like, they got to give it to you. They can't call you for the foul. You don't get those very often.
No, she's listed charitably at 5'5".
Yeah.
And pretty tough.
I think you came on the air talking about post players. You're going to be revoked from the point guard committee.
Gamecocks by one. Johnson turning on the basket. Trying to penetrate with that left hand and made it. Outstanding play and took the foul as well.
I'll tell you, this is a player who, before her ankle injury, has been dynamite for Mississippi State, and they need to get her back. Double crossover. How about the extension?
Lawson with the left hand. Double cross.
Don't double cross me, Kara Lawson.
Look at that off the window.
And she could go. She could go. A transfer from Oklahoma State is really good. I think as she grows and gets more comfortable and can give them a scoring punch off of the bench, we talked about offensively having other weapons than Vivian's. If this team wants to go deep, Johnson has that ability for them in terms of scoring.
It's a big story tonight, the fact that Mississippi State has only attempted half a dozen foul shots to this point. Usually they get to the line a ton. Gray off the front of the iron. And now the Bulldogs trying to add to this slender lead here as we approach the 1 minute mark to play in the third.
I just like their response, Dave. You know, they go down by four, they relinquish the lead. Things are coming apart on the road, but they hung tough.
Johnson hits 42% beyond the three. Shot clock at seven. Handing off for Williams. Shot clock at three. Two. Got the pass away, and they throw it away. On the turnover, here comes Davis. Davis, Cuevas, more from the corner. Oh, she had a great look. Gray, of course, with the rebound into the line. With a foul. Boy, she has become the go-to scorer in this second half for South Carolina.
Well, I think she flat decided, you know what? I'm done being outworked. I am done watching Mississippi State get every loose ball. So she checks in on the weak side. That's not a foul. You're taught that position. And McCowan, a weak challenge and another bad foul.
Her fourth. And Gray with the three-point play. Well, let's see if that turn. Kleine comes back on. And McCowan, the 6'7 sophomore, has to sit. Take a look at the foul trouble of Corey. And McCown with four and Dillingham with three for Mississippi State. A real issue all of a sudden. South Carolina in better shape. Although Coates has had to sit most of this quarter because of foul difficulty. Final seconds of the third. This one's shaping up to be a dandy at South Carolina tonight. William trying to put Mississippi State back in the lead. Johnson on the drive. Got it up in time, but it won't go, and we're set for the fourth quarter.
The winner of this game, in effect, has a two-game lead in the regular season race, so this is a big-time game.
How about Alicia Gray in that quarter equaled the entire Mississippi State scoring output? She had 13.
Exploding.
And though I had to beg onto the Around the Rim podcast, I will be on prior to the UConn South Carolina.
Oh, you are. You shamed everybody. Glad to see you got a little airtime, DB.
We might have to rope in Kara Lawson on that one.
I was on it this week.
Oh, you see that?
Yeah,
you just rub it in. Okay, Lipshine, I'm hearing that.
It was honoring Pat. Honoring Pat. Okay, I was on this week, right. So. Give Lipshine a pass.
Harris trying to attack, flips into the corner. Here's Gray again, taking the baseline. Made a nice little change there to go airborne for two more. She's making every shot.
Well, you close out hard. She's burned you from three, so you close out hard. She puts it on the deck and goes right at you.
One thing you got to love about Alicia Gray, especially if you're a coach, her expression never changes. Whether she's having a great game or not so great, she's having a great one tonight. Here she comes away with a loose ball. South Carolina on top, 51-48. Finds Davis in the corner. That's a round and out. But Coates is on the floor and playing with three fouls for South Carolina.
Boy, good weak side check out by Williams.
Bulldogs looking for a hot hand. Dillingham back to Richardson. Nine to get off a shot. Way downtown. All net by Johnson.
She changes the equation for them.
Rashonda Johnson at 42%. She opened up the season by scoring 21 against Villanova. She can fill it. Gray again to the baseline. Two more. Right now, they don't have an answer for her. South Carolina by two. Johnson has the last eight for Mississippi State. Richardson tied up. Possession arrow will be won by South Carolina on the stop by Wilson. She can play some serious defense.
I'll be honest with you.
you've seen Okoro and McCollum, who are high percentage finishers, be shy, and you don't blame them. When you get stuffed like that, it'll make you think twice. There's been a couple of times where Okoro's gotten offensive rebounds tonight, Kara, and flat thrown it to the other side of the rim, and I think Asia Wilson's presence has everything to do with that.
There's no question she's missed some bunnies, but I like the substitution back in just because you can't afford to get beaten on the glass.
Coach, tough rebound. Right back up, right into Okoro. Did a great job keeping her feet on the ground. Williams spinning it up there and lays it in. Tough shot. Tied at 53. Under 7.5 minutes to play here at South Carolina. It's the seventh time this game has been tied. Harris gave up the dribble. Coates out high. Six on the shot clock. Harris to drive it. Lost her footing. Out of play off the Bulldogs. And that's with 1 second on the shot clock.
I thought Vic Schaefer needed to get some size into the basketball game just exactly for this, and it's just having a presence there on the paint. You see, she gets Coates a little bit on those arms. Could have gone to the free throw line for two shots there, but you see the size and the presence, and when they were devoid of either of their centers, it's easier for Wilson and Coates on those putbacks.
Remember, 1 second to get one off here, so they've got to hustle. Wilson got it off in time, off the front of the iron, but it won't go. Bulldogs trying to retake the lead. They're up by 7 at halftime. Johnson for Chappell. William looking up at the shot clock, showing 7. Vivian's too strong that time. Coates tearing it down. She has 12 rebounds. And she sat for most of the third quarter. Coates intended for Wilson, but she's fouled with 6:19 to go.
It's a good call. She was undercut from behind on the backside help. Chappell is going to get caught behind. Her mistake was she allowed Wilson to cross her body. And in doing so, pushes her in the lower back.
Chappell, a 6'1 senior, certainly in there for her defense.
You know, had she stood up Asia Wilson, it might have been a foul anyway with the new rules, Dave.
Up top, Coates. Harris from the corner. In and out. And they certainly got the shot they wanted there, tied at 53. Approaching the 6-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. Vivian's their top scorer. Nice stop again by Wilson, and out of play off the Bulldogs.
She's now 4 for 13, and this is the play they run for her to get her moving left on the drive. But again, Wilson says twice on the pipes, nothing doing, this is my house.
She has 3 blocks and a timeout. So Don State
SEC title. This is the next step for Vic Schaefer's program, right? He's in the upper crust of the SEC right now. Can he win an SEC regular season title? That's what makes me fascinated to watch these last 6 minutes.
9 road wins for his team already. Can he get a 10th?
Best start in school history at 20-0. Joining UConn as the only unbeaten teams in women's college basketball.
Love the no call from DeCantor.
South Carolina with the basketball here on their home floor. Harris. Davis gave up the dribble, and now they give up the basketball, and Vivian's comes into the offensive zone. 17 points a game for her, and that's going to be a traveling violation. So both teams with key turnovers on the last 2 possessions.
Yeah, it's a little gun shy, right? I mean, Vivian's has driven and gotten blocked, and so she drives and she sees Wilson there, and then she stops. She's got to add a little pull up to her game, because she is easy to read at times on the offensive end. It's either 3 or get all the way to the hoop.
Well, Davis with a timeout, so as not to turn that shot blocker, a great shot blocker, has to have great feet. It's all about great footwork. Bill Russell used to say that. People who watched him when he was a young man said he would have been a brilliant boxer.
Yeah.
Because his footwork was, you know, beyond compare. You watch Asia Wilson to her size, and she is unbelievable on those feet. 5:15 to go. Tied at 53. Coates on the high post. Wilson wants it. In the lane, a dribble down, and got it. Exactly what they wanted, to take a two-point lead. She has 22. Chapel's pass almost didn't get there to Vivian. Here's Johnson with 10 to shoot it. She'll take the lane and a double dribble.
The bread and butter of South Carolina is their high-low game. The ball is going to be delivered, and it's going to take a little dribble here for Coach to get the kind of passing angle she wants. But Kara, you know what I love about Coach? She's unselfish. She's not a black hole, but she could drop step either way. She's an outstanding finisher. I love her willingness to distribute the basketball.
They have great synergy between the two of them, and it's very much needed. Great set play there, end out of bounds.
McCollum on the entry pass, and they had called a foul on Gray of the Gamecocks, her third. That allowed him to hold on to that as William picks it up and gets it off to Blair Schaefer, the coach's daughter. She's getting her first minutes here. Shot clock down to 12. Chapel with it. Shot clock at 7. Schaefer on the penetration. Got it up there, but it won't fall. Gray knocked to the floor on a foul. McCollum will pick up the personal. She has just fouled out. Not this time. And Mississippi State fumbles it away. Back to South Carolina. Gamecocks up by 1.
Keep in mind, Schaefer against Tennessee made huge buckets at the end of 3 different quarters, and so he was hoping for a little magic there.
We've got to believe the Bulldogs need to find a way to get the basketball into Victoria Vivian's hands down the stretch. That's going to be a foul on Chapel reaching.
I'll tell you, that's a tough one, and it got Vic Schaefer really upset, and he's still barking. And the reason he's barking is he believes that Wilson is giving as good as she gets in there.
So 3:06 to go, and a one-point game.
4 team fouls on Mississippi State as we march down to the 3-minute mark. 4 team fouls on Mississippi State, just 1 on South Carolina. Remember, on the 5th foul in women's basketball, 2 shots every time after the 4th foul.
Wilson on the inbounds. Harris. Gray has really been a star tonight. Asia Wilson. Yes! Not to be stopped. 24 points in a huge game. 10 for 13. This big crowd noisy. Vivian's not there. Rebound tipped, and it's Wilson again.
I like that Dawn Staley told Kayla Davis, you're checking Victoria Vivian's. Get to work.
Harris running the point. 10 on the shot clock for South Carolina. Coates commanding the ball. Kind of a wild shot. She was harassed defensively, and out it goes. Back over to the Bulldogs. 58-55 South Carolina, trying to be the first team this season to hang Mississippi State with a loss. Okorie and McCollum, the bigs, are out, fouled out for Mississippi State. So they have to do it with a smaller lineup if they're going to do it. Campbell underneath, and the freshman hits it.
Wow, how about that delivery in a big spot? My goodness gracious, touch it, score it.
Again, she's played all of 23 minutes all season as William commits the foul. Those were her third and fourth points all season.
Yeah, you look like you're going to send your guards through and said your guards set a screen. I'll tell you what, Vic Schaefer, a cold play for Campbell despite the minutes that she's played. Wow.
I wasn't sure she was going to get it up in time. I was worried. I started to get nervous for her. They were coming. Coach and Wilson were coming.
My goodness.
Harris buries the first, a 63% shooter there.
Bad foul by William.
Yeah.
Bad foul by William.
Yeah, to put Harris at the line here for two.
I have the feeling she's trying to make a play and pressure because she knows what's coming, right? They're going to go bury us in the paint. Let me see if I can't keep it out of there.
Look at all those foul shots for South Carolina. 26. Yeah. Mississippi State only 6. Vivians pulls up the dribble, looking for help. A minute and a half to play. Vivians drawing the foul well away from the basket with 1:29 to go.
But again, only the second foul on South Carolina in the quarter. My goodness. Wow. There wasn't a whole lot there, Dave O'Brien.
Not much. Underneath, Richardson to the other side of the iron. Nicely done there. And again, it is a one-point game.
You could see if the pressure from Mississippi State on the perimeter can keep it out of that high-low game.
.107 left. Gray is open and can't hit. Rebound tipped into the corner. Harris for the save. Back for William. That triggers the break. Here's Vivian's. Gray over defensively. And she made all the difference there.
Time and score here. Somebody needs to come get command of the basketball. And Dawn Staley actually has to tap her freshman Harris and say, go get it.
Boy, a huge miss there by Vivian's.
You've got to go inside. There should be no excuse for your interior players not to touch it. Coates or Wilson.
33 seconds to go, 7 on the shot clock. Harris off to Coates. Coates on the attack, will lay it in. A giant shot. Timeout, Mississippi State. Last week against Notre Dame, it was huge the way they executed and bled away that clock in a key circumstance down the stretch. Donata inbound right in front of their own bench. 23 seconds left, and there's one of the fouls.
See, I might have let her have another dribble or two before, and this is why it's so important, right? This is the same thing as when you're down. Do you foul the three-point shooter before they get to the three? You got to practice these situations. I would have let another dribble or two go.
Harris with her third foul. Bounced in for Richardson. Fires it up there, in and out with the foul. How about that? It nearly went.
Did they signal three?
Yes. So in the act of shooting the three, what if that one had gone down by Vivian's?
It's absolutely the right call.
So that put Vivian's at the line, one of the better foul shooters for the Bulldogs. Again, they're just 1 for 6 all night, now 2 for 7.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. No doubt, right on that direct shooting line. That's amazing. She almost put that one in.
Vivian's with her second. Got that, another one coming. How about this? And she can tie up the ball game by making this with 18.6 seconds to go. Vivian's a 76% foul shooter. The junior. In and out. Tipped out of play, and it will be South Carolina ball.
And Dee Cantner, I think, is signaling a review, and rightly so. And this is something you can look at. Oh, it looks like, is that Wilson's left hand on the inside of that?
And the two players are going for it inside the last 2 minutes.
Right, and the call on the floor was
South Carolina ball.
And so it has to be compelling video evidence to the contrary.
So 17.2 seconds remaining. This one under review to see in the end who does get.
And I want two chances to win this thing. And I also want an opportunity to put him on the free throw line. I want to go pretty quick, Dave. I want to get as quality a look as I can, as fast as I can.
The long delay was essentially a timeout for Mississippi State. In for Richardson. They have one timeout remaining. Vivians on the drive. Bouncing for Schaefer. She can't hit it. Battle for the rebound. A tie up on the play. Possession arrow will keep it on this end for Mississippi State with 6.5 seconds to play. Schaefer, the coach's daughter, got the look from the corner, could not knock it down.
So they run the little circle action, understanding everybody's going to commit to Vivian's, and they stay spaced.
Now, who gets the basketball?
Well, they were working with a lot more time. Remember, Williams took it, and then a little exchange to Vivian's. You don't have that kind of time here.
William to get it in. No one defending her. Still looking. Still looking. They're out of timeouts. The jumper well short. Wilson comes away with it. A slap and a foul with 2.5 to go. And it never got to the iron. And South Carolina, with a one-point lead, will go to the other end and shoot. William picking up her fourth foul. Take a look at the play.
South Carolina defensively, they crowded and they loaded up to that strong side. Just not enough real estate for Vivian to get a shot off.
Excuse me, but Davis flat out runs over Schaefer. I thought that could have been a foul, too.
Could have been.
An unfriendly whistle twice now for Big Schaefer.
Wilson at the line is 4 for 6. She makes 69%.
Now, you talk about, as there's the play where she doesn't get it up. She's trying to slide between two.
Wilson with another one coming. Makes the pair in the clutch. 64-61. Time for a heave. William gets it up there. And it won't go. And that's the game. And South Carolina.